Hello students, today we are going to learn the half moon coding. These are the steps for the half moon coding. Please note down it. The step number first is you have to arrange your symbols or the probability in the decreasing order. That means same as the Shannon Fano. The largest probability at the top and the lowest probability at the bottom. Okay, after that you have to combine the least two probabilities and assign the bit as a 0 and 1. That means the last two probabilities you have to add them, and the 0 is assigned to the first probability and 1 is assigned to the second probability. Then combine the last two symbols and move the combined symbols as high as possible. That means again in first stage you have to arrange the all probabilities in the decreasing order or descending order. Repeat the all steps, above steps until the end. You have to repeat the all these steps up to the single probability comes. Okay. Code for each symbols and is found by the moving backward. So I will explain these steps at the time of the example. In this half moon coding, you have to do the calculation for the efficiency, which is H divided by L log of, this is R actually, but if R is 2, then log 2, R is 3, log 3, and R is 4, log 4. If R is equal to 2, you have to use the symbol 1 and 2. If R is equal to 3, you have to use the symbol 0, 1, and 2. And if R is equal to 4, you have to use the symbol 0, 1, 2, 3. Average code word, that is length, is summation of 1 to n probability and its code length. H is nothing but as usual its entropy, and variance is the sigma square summation probability into bracket its code word length and total length bracket raised to 2. So variance should be as low as possible. Okay, let us take one example of half moon coding. Find the code length, code word length of symbol S1 to S5 with the probabilities 0.4, 0.2, 0.2, 0.1 and 0.1. Find the half moon codes and also find the efficiency and variance. Okay, so first of all, write the symbol in its descending order and its respective probability. In this example, the order is given is already in descending way. Okay, so I write the symbol name as it is: S1, S2, S3, S4, and S5 with the respective probabilities is 0.4. 0.2, 0.2, 0.1 and 0.1. Okay. In first stage, as I told in the procedure, you have to combine these last two probabilities, 0.1 and 0.1. Right. Assign the 0 to the first probability and assign the 1 to the second probability. So 0.1 plus 0.1, it becomes the 0.2. So already we have the 0.2 for the symbol S2 and 0.2 again for the symbol S3. You have to combine this probability with its highest priority. Okay, so in the stage 1, so 0.4 as it is, this probability goes to this place 0.2. This 0.2 becomes at the lower level and this 0.2 becomes at this level, right? Okay, so assign the symbols, assign the symbols 0 and 1. Okay, again in next stage, suppose stage 2, you have to again combine last two probabilities. Okay, so 0.2 plus 0.2, it becomes 0.4. Place it its to the highest priority, so it becomes the 0.4. Assign the symbol 0 and 1, so this 0.4 becomes here, this 0.2 becomes here. Clear? Again, so 0.4 plus 0.2 in stage 3. So 0.4 plus 0.2, it becomes 0.6. So it place to the highest priority, assign the 0 and 1 symbol, and this 0.4 becomes at this place. Again, these two, 0 and 1. After that, we don't want don't combine these two probability. These are the single probability, as well as code is also assigned to this. At this stage, we should stop here. Okay. So after that, we have to calculate the code for the same. So it is a symbol S1, S2, S3, S4, and S5. Okay, respective code word. Okay, and calculate its length. So I will explain the last step in this. So if you check, calculate the code for the S1. So S1 is here. So S1 have the probability is 0.4. Go to the forward direction for the symbol. Go to forward direction for the symbol like S1, 0.4, 0.4, 0.4, 0, sorry, from 0 to here 0.6, because this 0.4 is added here with this 0.2, and we'll get the 0.6 as a result, and its symbol is 0. So while calculating the code word, you have to check in reverse direction. So that means the first is 0, again it comes here, again it is a 0, and there is a no code word assigned to the same symbol. I repeating, for the S1 you have to do in this direction, in this the 0.4 is added with 0.2, so 0.6 becomes, and 0.6, for the 0.6 0 is assigned. So for the while calculating the code word, so 0, again 0, and repeating. Okay, same way for the S2, 0.2, so 0.2 in first stage as it is 0.2, so it's a 0, again this 0.2 becomes added with the 0.2, and it goes to the next direction up state, and in this way. So in reverse direction, the 1 1, after that 0, and no. Okay, so 1 and 0 is code word. Similar way you can calculate the all codes. For example, if you want to calculate the for the code for the S3, so S3 0.2 probability, 0.2 have the code, I already write here, 0.2 the code have the 1, again it is added with this 0.2, again it is go to, and this 1, so 1 1 1. For S4, 0, so I higher most probability 0, this 0.1 is added with here, again 0.2 0.2, the 1 will come. After that, it is added with this and 0. Again, S5, 1, write 1 here, added with this 2, again 1 at this place, and it is added with the 0.4 and 0. Right? So, the for the S1, the code will appear 00, S2, 10, S3, 11. S4 010 and S5 011. The length will become 2 2 2 3 3, right? So entropy will become summation k is equal to 1 to n pk log of 1 divided by pk, right? So it becomes 0.4 log of 1 divided by 0.4 plus 2 into 0.2 log 1 divided by 0.2 plus 2 into 0.1 log 1 divided by 0.1. So it will comes approximately, I think, 2.1216 bits per symbol. Okay, after that you have to calculate the efficiency, L bar. You have to calculate the L bar. L bar is summation I is equal to 1 to n pi ni. Ni is the length of the code and pi is the respective probability, right? So first probability is 0.4 multiplied by its code length, is 2 plus 2 into 0.2 plus 3 into 0.1 into 2. So it approximately becomes 2.2 bits per symbol. Then calculate the efficiency. Efficiency H divided by L log of L divided by log of 2, because here R is 2 to the base 2, so it becomes 96.4%. Next, calculate the variance. Variance is summation I is equal to 1 to n pi into ni is the length of the code, L bracket square. So it becomes 0.4 into 2 minus 2.2, because length is 2.2 bracket square, plus 2 into 0.2 into 2 minus 2.2 bracket square. Next is plus 2 into 0.1 into 3 minus 2.2 bracket square. Okay, so it becomes 0.16. As I told, the variance should be as low as possible for good coding algorithm. Okay, so you can compare the same example with the Shannon-Fano coding, and you can compare, comment on the same, right? Okay, thank you.